glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of our God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of you always.
And with your spirit.
As we take these moments to gather in faith, let's turn to the God who fills us with his grace and with his life, and seek mercy and rejoice in the forgiveness of our sin.
You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And so may Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sin. May God bring us to everlasting life. So let us pray. Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory may experience, as he promised, until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us. We make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives, who reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Jesus had been taken up to heaven, the apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day journey away. When they entered the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women, and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, rejoice to the extent that you share in the sufferings of Christ, so that when his glory is revealed, you may also rejoice exultantly. If you are insulted for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. But let no one among you be made to suffer as a murderer, a thief, an evildoer, or as an intruder. But whoever is made to suffer as a Christian should not be ashamed, but glorify God because of the name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Give glory to your Son, so that your Son may glorify you. Just as you gave him authority over all people, so that your Son may give eternal life to all you gave him. Now this is eternal life, that they should know, excuse me, that they should know you, the only true God, and the one whom you sent, Jesus Christ. I glorified you on earth by accomplishing the work that you gave me to do. Now glorify me, Father, with you, with the glory that I had with you before the world began. I revealed your name to those whom you gave me out of the world. They belong to you, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you gave me is from you, because the words you gave to me, I have given to them. And they accepted them, truly understood that I came from you. They have believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for the ones you have given me, because they are yours, and everything of mine is yours, and everything of yours is mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I will no longer be in the world, but they are in the world, while I am coming to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Once again, whether it be good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, it's good that we are with each other as we mark with the church throughout the world this seventh Sunday in the Easter season, continuing to unpack the mystery of the Lord's resurrection beyond the mystery that we name death. And not only unpacking that mystery for him personally, but for ourselves and its implications for believing people throughout our world. In fact, this Sunday is kind of a blending of two feasts, Not only that of the Lord's resurrection, but this past Thursday, we mark the feast of the Lord's ascension into heaven, where he, as our brother, and yet as our Savior and Lord, sits at God's right hand to intercede for us. And during these continuing days of pandemic, isn't it good to know that the Lord is there pleading on our behalf? And so we place our trust, we place our faith in the mystery of both his resurrection and his ascension into glory. Next weekend, when we gather, we'll celebrate the Feast of Pentecost, his promise of sending us an advocate, a spirit that would fill us with courage and with strength, even in the face of suffering, as did those first disciples, and as so many people in our world continue to do, simply because they proclaim that Jesus Christ is their Lord and is their Savior. You may be aware that we're beginning to receive some news about the reopening of places of worship. And while we're moving in that direction, right now we have permission to only gather with 10 people or fewer, at least within our church buildings. That may change over the course of this coming week or the weeks ahead, so we'll be communicating with you as much as we can and as effectively as we can. Certainly, getting permission to return to worship is one reality, but doing all that it will take to open our doors is another reality. And so you'll be receiving a letter, if you are a registered parishioner, either of Our Lady of the Rosary or of Our Lady of Lourdes, trying to address some of the issues that we will face in reopening our church doors in the weeks ahead. I hope you will read those letters carefully. I hope you will respond to them as quickly as you possibly can, so that we can return to gather with each other to give praise to the God who fills us with his Holy Spirit and allows us to share in the resurrected life of his Son and of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Until then, have a blessed week. Know the strength of that Spirit as we continue to endure these days of pandemic. We pray for the sick. We pray with great gratitude for those who continue to minister to them and their needs. We continue to pray for people who suffer anywhere, for any reason, throughout our world. And so before we approach the table of our great Thanksgiving, let's profess our faith and do so through the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And so, in the name of Jesus Christ, through the power of the Holy Spirit, we offer prayers and petitions for one another, for members of the church in every part of the world.
For the church on earth, may God increase her in holiness. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For world leaders who followed the example of Christ, may God help them in their service to their people and the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians throughout the world who are suffering for their faith in Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community rejoicing as an Easter people, may God bless our efforts to protect the dignity and sanctity of human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in faith, may they rejoice in the light of God's glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And so we take a moment to add personal intentions in silence. We ask all these things through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my sisters and my brothers, that our sacrifice be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our sins. Praise and glory his name for our good and good brothers.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of eternal life, all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. It is our duty. It is our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus our Lord and brother. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every people, every land, exalt in your praise and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and he entered willingly into his own passion, we remember that he took bread, and that giving thanks, he broke it, and then gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when that supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and of the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come
So, gathered in faith, we celebrate the memorial of Jesus' death and resurrection. And it is as a people that we offer you, Lord, the bread that gives us life, the chalice that brings us salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence, that we might minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And so, Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring the church to the fullness of your love, the depth of your charity and compassion. Together with Francis, our Pope, with Douglas, our Bishop, with all of the clergy, and with all who serve, who minister to your people. Remember also sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, we pray, into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God and the Mother of the Church, with Joseph, her loving husband, with the apostles, and with all of the saints who have pleased you throughout every age, we may indeed merit to be co-heirs to your gift of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him,
O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Whether it be physical, emotional, mental, or spiritual, let's pray for the healing of the human family as we now offer the words our Savior has taught us and say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our brokenness, look not on our sin, but look always on the faith of your church and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You who live, who reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the risen and ascended Lord be with you always.
With your spirit. And let us acknowledge each other with a greeting of peace.
Peace, John. Peace. Have a blessed week. Peace, Cornelius. Have a blessed week. Weekend. Run well. Thank you. Peace, Dennis. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring each of us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries, there will be accomplished in the body of the whole church what has already come to pass in Christ, her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May I take a moment before we leave today to thank you not only for your faithfulness to worship, but your faithfulness, so many of you, for the sacrifices that you are making financially to keep our parish strong. This week, you should be receiving a letter from me, either via email, if you have that, if you've given us your email address, or through snail mail, no matter what parish you belong to, Our Lady of the Rosary, Our Lady of Lourdes, helping to prepare us, we hope, in the very near future, for a reopening of our doors. When we do gather in groups larger than 10, see the mask I'm wearing? I'm sure it will be one of the many new things we'll have to be accustomed to as we gather with each other to celebrate Christ's presence in word, in Eucharist, and in our gathering. And finally, even though we remain in the midst of a pandemic, God has blessed us with beautiful weather this past week. Sunny days, warm days, renewing us in body, mind, and spirit. I hope you've taken advantage of enjoying them just a little bit. And it's that time of year for me to tell all of you, have a little ice cream on the way. So the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And our Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.